Yeshayahu, Isaiah 37. And it came to pass, when King Yachizyahu heard it, that he rent at his clothes and covered himself with sackcloth and went into the house of Yahuwah. And he sent at Eliakim, who was over the household, and at Shivna, the scribe, and the at elders of the priests, covered with sackcloth, unto Eliashiyahu, the prophet, the son of Amoz. And they said unto him, Thus says Yachizkiyahu, This day is a day of trouble, and of rebuke, and of blasphemy. For the children are come to the birth, and there is not strength to bring forth. It may be Yahuwah Eloheka will hear eth the words of Rav Shache, whom the king of Ashur, his master, has sent to reproach the living Elohim, and will reprove the words which Yahuwah Eloheka has heard. Wherefore lift up your prayer for the remnant that is left. So the servants of King Yachizkiyahu came to Yeshayahu, and Yeshayahu said unto them, Thus shall ye say unto your master, Thus says Yahuwah, Be not afraid of the words that you have heard, wherewith the servants of the king of Ashur have blasphemed me. Behold, I will send a blast upon him, and he shall hear a rumor, and return to his own land, and I will cause him to fall by the sword in his own land. So Rav Shache returned, and found that the king of Ashur warring against Livna, for he had heard that he was departed from Lachish. And he heard say concerning Tirhaka, king of Cush, He has come forth to make war with you. And when he heard it, he sent messengers to Yachizkiyahu, saying, Thus shall ye speak to Yachizkiyahu, king of Yehuda, saying, Let not your Elohim, in whom you trust, deceive you, saying, Yerushalayim shall not be given into the hand of the king of Ashur. Behold, you have heard what the king of Ashur have done to all lands by destroying them utterly, and shall you be delivered? Have the Elohim of the nations delivered them which my fathers have destroyed, as Eth Gozan, and Eth Haran, and Reseph, and the children of Edan, which were in Telassar? Where is the king of Hamath, and the king of Arpad, and the king of the city of Sepharvaim, Hena, and Ava? And Yachizkiyahu received the Sefer from the hand of the messengers and read it. And Yachizkiyahu went up unto the house of Yahuwah and spread it before Yahuwah. And Yachizkiyahu prayed unto El Yahuwah, saying, O Yahuwah Sevaoth, the Elohai of Yashara'el, that dwell between the Keravim, you are the Elohim, even you alone, of all the kingdoms of the earth. You have made eth the heavens and eth the earth. Incline your ear, O Yahuwah, and hear. Open your eyes, O Yahuwah, and see. And hear eth all the words of Kencher, Eve, which has sent to reproach the living Elohim. Of a truth, Yahuwah, the king of, rather, kings of Ashur, have laid waste eth all the nations and eth their countries, and have cast eth their Elohim into the fire, for they were no Elohim, but the work of men's hands, wood and stone. Therefore they have destroyed them. Now therefore, O Yahuwah Eloheinu, save us from his hand, that all the kingdoms of the earth may know that you are Yahuwah, even you only. Then Yeshayahu, the son of Amoz, sent unto Yachizkiyahu, saying, Thus says Yahuwah Elohai of Yashara'el, whereas you have prayed to me against Kencherkiz, king of Ashur, this is the word which Yahuwah has spoken concerning him. The virgin, the daughter of Sion, has despised you, and laughed you to scorn. The daughter of Yerushalayim has shaken her head at you. Whom have you reproached and blasphemed? And against whom have you exalted your voice and lifted up your eyes on high? Even against the Holy One of Yashar'el. By your servants have you reproached Adonai and have said, by the multitude of my chariots am I come up to the height of the mountains, to the sides of Lebanon, and I will cut down the tall cedars thereof, and the choice fir trees thereof, and I will enter into the height of his border, and the forest of his Carmel. I have dug and drunk water, and with the sole of my feet have I dried up all the rivers of the besieged places. Have you not heard long ago how I have done it, and of ancient times that I have formed it? Now have I brought it to pass, that you should be to lay waste defensed cities into ruinous heaps. Therefore their inhabitants were of small power. They were dismayed and confounded. They were as the grass of the field, and as the green herb, as the grass on the housetops, and as grain blasted before it be grown up. But I know your abode, and your going out, and your coming in, and doth your rage against me. Because your rage against me, and your tumult, is come up into my ears, therefore will I put my hook in your nose, and my bridle in your lips, and I will turn you back by the way by which you came. And this shall be a sign unto you, ye shall eat this year such as grows of itself, and the second year that which springs of the same, and in the third year sow ye and reap, and plant vineyards, and eat the fruit thereof. And the remnant that is escaped of the house of Yahudah shall again take root downward, and bear fruit upward. For out of Yerushalayim shall go forth a remnant, and they that escaped out of Mount Zion, the zeal of Yahuwah Sevaoth, shall do this. Therefore thus says Yahuwah concerning the king of Ashur, he shall not come into this city, nor shoot an arrow there, nor come before it with shields, nor cast a bank against it. By the way that he came, by the same shall he return, and shall not come into this city, says Yahuwah. For I will defend this city, to save it for my own sake, and for my David's, rather, and for my servant David's sake. Then the angel of Yahuwah went forth and smote in the camp of the Asharim 185,000. And when they arose early in the morning, behold, they were all dead corpses. So Kenker Sharif, king of Ashur, departed and went and returned and dwelt at Nineveh. And it came to pass, as he was worshipping in the house of Nichrach, his Elohim, that Adrammelech and Shar-Etzer, his sons, smote him with the sword, and they escaped into the land of Ararat. And Ichar, Chadan, his son, reigned in his stead.